Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so now we do an extra exercise on topic line. Okay, so first question. Consider the straight line L1, kx minus 2y plus 5 equal to 0. Okay, so ada line yang pertama ni, persamaannya adalah kx tolak 2y tambah 5 sama dengan 0. Okay, so find the question, find the values of k if for the a the slope is 3 and b if the line 1, so line yang pertama tu, is perpendicular to 2x plus 3y equal to 4. Okay, so dia berkaitan dengan gradient lah, slope ni gradient. Okay, so first we need to rearrange the equation of the line 1 in the form of y equal to mx plus c. Okay, so we have kx minus 2y plus 5 equal to 0. Okay, so negative 2y equal to negative kx minus by 5. Okay, so y equal to negative kx minus 5 divided by negative 2. So which is equal to negative k divided by negative 2. So k over 2x. Negative 5 divided by negative 2. Positive 5 over 2. Okay. So this is the gradient k over 2. And the slope given for equation A, slope given is 3. Okay, so therefore k over 2, the gradient, is equal to 3. So k is equal to 6. B, so B dikata perpendicular to the line of 2x plus 3y equal to 4. Okay, so kita kena susun yang ni dalam bentuk y equal to mx plus c juga. Okay, so we have 3y equal to 4 minus by 2x. Okay, so susunlah biasa x kat depan kan. So 3y equal to negative 2x plus 4. So y equal to negative 2x plus 4 over by 3 equal to negative 2 divided by 3. So negative 2 over 3x, positive 4 divided by 3. So plus 4 over 3. Okay, so this is the gradient for the second line, for this line. And this is the gradient for the line 1, L1. Okay, so since it is perpendicular, so we use M1 times M2 equal to negative 1. Okay, so M1 is k over 2. M2 is negative 2 over 3, which is equal to negative 1. Okay, so kat sini darab. Okay, so ni 2 dekat bawah, 2 dekat atas, kita boleh cancel. Okay, so therefore we have negative k over 3 equal to negative 1. Okay, so from this one we have negative k equal to negative 1 times by 3, which is negative 3. So k is equal to 3. Okay, so next question. The coordinates of point A and B are negative 1, 2 and 1, 1 respectively. Okay, so yang pertama ni point untuk A, yang kedua ni point untuk B. Okay, so a line, a straight line BC, so kita ada lagi satu line, straight line BC, is perpendicular to the straight line AB. Okay, so kita ada straight line AB, so ni point A and point B. And then BC perpendicular to the line AB. Nah, so kita akan ada satu lagi line BC. Okay, so ni BC. Okay, so perpendicular. Okay, so A dengan B kita ada titik dia negative 1, 2, and B is 1, 1. Okay, so find the equation of the straight line BC. Okay, so kita nak equation yang ni. Okay, so to find the equation of straight line BC, what we need? Gradient and one point to find C. Okay, so sebab y equal to mx plus c. So we need gradient and one point to find value of c. Okay, so one point we have this one b. Okay, so b c. Okay, so boleh pakai a? Tak boleh. Kenapa? Sebab a ni tak ada dekat line b c. So yang ada dekat line b c ni adalah point b. Okay, so sekarang one point dah ada. The only left kita yang tak ada adalah gradient. So to find the gradient, so kita ada kat sini perpendicular. So kalau perpendicular ni mungkin dia akan kait dengan M1, M2 equal to negative 1. Okay, okay, so first we need to find the gradient of this line. Okay, so gradient of AB. Okay, so the gradient of line AB is equal to, so different in y, which is 1 minus by 2, divide by 1 minus by negative 1. Okay, so we have 1 minus 2 negative 1. 1 minus negative 1 is 1 plus 1, which is 2. So we have negative 1 over 2. Okay, so kita dah ada yang ni, kecurunan untuk line AB, which is negative 1 over 2. And then we find the gradient of BC. Okay, so gunakan konsep yang ni. Okay, so gradient of line AB times the gradient of line BC is equal to negative 1 over 2. Sebabnya B dengan line BC ni perpendicular. Bukan 1 over 2, salah. Is equal to negative 1. Okay, sebabnya line AB dengan BC ni perpendicular. Okay, so gradient of line AB is negative 1 over 2 times by gradient of line BC equal to negative 1. Okay, so next, gradient of line BC is equal to, okay, so this one divide by 2, bring to the left is times by 2. Okay, so nak bawa negatif ni pun boleh sekali. Okay, so negatif ni kita boleh letak dekat negatif 2. So times by negative 2. So you have M gradient of line BC equal to 2. Okay, so next we use Y equal to MX plus C. Gradient kita dah ada, point pun kita dah ada. So Y equal to M, which is 2 X C. Okay, so to find C, use the point given. Okay, so yang ada ni, which is 1 and 1. So 1 value for x, so 2 times by 1, and y is 1 plus c. So 1 equal to 2 plus c, so we have c equal to 1 minus by 2, which is negative 1. Therefore the equation of the straight line BC is equal to y equal to mx 2x. Okay, so plus c, c is negative 1 minus by 1. Okay, so next question. Okay, so find the general equation of the line which is parallel to the line 2x plus 5y equal to 3 and passes through point negative 1, 3. Okay, so general equation of the line. Okay, so still the equation of the straight line, cuma dia nak dalam bentuk general. So general form lah ni. So kalau dalam bentuk general form ni macam mana? So general form ni yang sebelah kanan tu sama dengan kosong. So semua kena pindah ke kiri. Okay, so nanti kita tengok. Okay, so line. So line ni parallel dengan line 2x plus 5 equal to 3. Okay, so this is the line. And then parallel to another one line. So line ni ada line 2x plus 5y equal to 3. Okay, so passes through point negative 1, 3. So line ni dia melalui titik negative 1, 3. Okay, so to find equation of this line, so we need, okay, so y equal to mxc. So we need gradient and one point to find C. Okay, so So 1 point already have here, negative 1, 3. Gradient yang tak ada, okay. So nak cari gradient macam mana? Since this line parallel to this line, so therefore both line will share the same gradient, okay. Okay, so line-line ni akan berkongsi kecerunan yang sama. Okay, so therefore for this line we have the equation. So we need to rearrange this one in the form of y equal to mx plus c in order to obtain the gradient. Okay, so 5y equal to 3 minus by 2x. Okay, so y equal to 3 minus 2x divided by 5. So letaklah x kat depan. So negative 2 divided by 5. Negative 2 divided by x. And then this one positive 3 divided by 5. So plus 3 divided by 5, okay. So the gradient is negative 2 over 5, okay. So therefore the equation of the straight line, line, so untuk line yang ni y equal to mx, since dia kongsi kecerunan yang sama sebab dia parallel, so y equal to negative 2 over 5 x plus c, okay. So c we need to find by using the point given, so value of x, value of y. So 3 equal to negative 2 over 5, x is negative 1 plus c. 3, negative 2 over 5 times negative 1, positive 2 over 5 plus c. Okay, so we have here c equal to 3 minus 2 over 5. So 3 minus 2 over 5, 15 minus 2, 13. So 13 over 5. Okay, so therefore the equation is y equal to mx negative 2 over 5x plus c. So c is positive 13 over 5, okay. So nak cantik darabkan dengan 5. So 5y equal to negative 2x plus 13, okay. So dia nak general equation. So general equation yang sebelah kanan ni kita biarkan dia kosong. So semua ni we need to bring to the left, okay. So we have negative 2x become positive 2x plus 5y plus 13, bring to the left, minus 13. So which is equal to 0, okay. Okay, so next question. Okay, so find the equation of the straight line which passes through to 1. Okay, so we have a line and then passes through a point to 1. It is perpendicular to the line 2y plus 3x minus 2. Okay, so dia perpendicular dengan satu line, yang mana line tu adalah 2y plus 3x minus 2 equal to 0. Okay, so for this line, to find the equation of this line, we need gradient and 1 point to find c, okay. So 1 point we already have here, this one 2n1, okay. So next we need to find is gradient, okay. So gradient, since it is perpendicular to another line, so 2y plus 3x minus 2 equal to 0, so we can use m1 times m2 equal to negative 1, okay. So for this line, so we need to rearrange in the form of y equal to mx plus c. Okay, so 2y equal to this one, bring to the right, minus 3x, negative 2 bring to the right, plus 2. Okay, so y is equal to negative 3 over 2x plus 2 over 2. So equal to negative 3 over 2x plus by 1, okay. So using this concept, okay, so this is the gradient of this line. So negative 3 over 2. So negative 3 over 2 times by m2 is equal to negative 1. So m2 is equal to negative 1 divided by negative 3 over 2. So negative divided by negative become positive. So 1 times by 2 over 3. Okay, so korang guna je lah kalkulator. So jawapan dia 2 over 3. Okay. So the gradient of this line is 2 over 3. Okay, so kita dah ada dah, which is m equal to 2 over 3. Okay, so therefore next we can use y equal to mx plus c. So m over 3 x plus c. Okay, so to use the point given 2 and 1. So 2 is for x, 1 for y, plus c, and then calculate c. Okay, so we have negative c equal to 1 minus 4 over 3, which is negative 1 over 3. Okay, so therefore the equation of the straight line is equal to y equal to mx 2 over 3x plus c minus 1 over 3. Okay, so all of this 1 times by 3. So y times by 3y, 2 over 3x times by 3 equal to 2x, negative 1 over 3 times by 3 is negative 3. Okay. So darab 3 sebab kita nak cantik sikit, tak nak ada pecahan ni. So next, berapa banyak soalan ni? 8. Okay, so ada 8 soalan. So next, number 5. So find the general equation of straight line which passes through 1, 2 and perpendicular to the line 9y plus 6x minus 8 equal to 0. Okay. So kita ada line, dia melalui titik 1, 2. Okay. So then dia perpendicular kepada line 9y plus 6x minus 8 equal to 0. Okay, so we need to find the equation of this line. Okay. So what we need? Gradient and one point. So one point to find C. Okay. So one point we already have 1, 2. Okay. Next gradient. So gradient, since this one is perpendicular, so we can use m1 times m2 equal to 0. Okay. So m1 times m2. So first we need to find the gradient of this line. Okay, so for this line. Okay, so we need to rearrange in the form of y equal to mx plus c. So 9y, 9y equal to negative 6x plus 8. So y equal to negative 6 divided by 9x plus 8 over 9. Okay, so negative 6 over 9. Okay, simplify 3. So negative 2 over 3x plus 8 over 9. So therefore by using m1 times m2 equal to not 0, it is negative 1. Okay. So m1 times m2 equal to negative 1. So we have negative 2 over 3 times by m2 equal to negative 1. So m2 equal to negative 1 divided by negative 2 over 3. Okay. So negative negative positive. So 1 times by 3 over 2. Okay. So the gradient for the second line is 3 over 2. Okay. So dah ada gradient, which is 3 over 2. We form the equation of the straight line, which is y equal to mx. So 3 over 2x plus c. Okay, so to find c, we use the point given, which is 1, 2. So value for x is 1, y is 2, plus c. Okay, so 3 over 2 times by 1, so 3 over 2. Okay, so 2 minus by 3 over 2 plus c. Not plus c. Equal to c. Okay. Okay, so yang ni kita bawa pergi ke kiri. D minus 3 over 2. Okay, so c is equal to 1 over 2. Okay. So next, the equation of the straight line is y equal to mx 3 over 2x plus c, which is 1 over 2. Okay, so times by 2. Okay, so to cancel the denominator, so we have 2y equal to 3x plus 1. And then equation need us to find the general equation. Okay, so we need to leave it this one equal to 0. Okay, so this one we need to bring to the left. So we have 2y minus 3x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so next question. Okay, so this one. So for general equation of straight line, which y intercept is 6. Okay, so ini kita ada paksi y. Kita potong dekat paksi y dekat 6. And then perpendicular to the line of, okay, so the perpendicular to the line of y equal y minus 5x here, okay, 5x minus 9 equal to 0. Okay. Okay, so to find the equation of this line, so we need again we need gradient and 1 point. Okay, so 1 point tu ada ke tak? Ada. So this one, y intercept. Okay, so y intercept, okay, you should know at y intercept value of x is equal to 0. Okay, so therefore 1 point is 0, 6. Okay. Okay, so dekat pintasan paksi ini kita tahu nilai x dia adalah kosong. Okay, so therefore point yang kita perlukan adalah 0, 6. Okay. So next, find gradient. It is perpendicular, so we use m1 times m2 equal to negative 1. Okay. So gradient of the line 1, so we can use from this equation. Okay, so rearrange in the form of y equal to mx plus c. So y equal to 5x plus 9. Okay, so m1 equal to 5. Okay, so therefore 5 times by m2 is equal to negative 1. M2 equal to negative 1 over 5. Okay, dah ada gradient. Okay, so we form the equation of the straight line, y equal to mx negative 1 over 5x plus by c. Okay, so to find c, use the point given 0, 6. So 0 for x, 6 for y. So 6 is equal to negative 1 over 5 times by 0 plus c. Okay, so c equal to 6. Okay. Dan lagi satu, sebenarnya c itu adalah y intercept lah. Okay. So kalau yang tak nak banyak apa, tak nak apa banyak-banyak sangat tu, tak kisahlah, ikutlah apa yang saya cakap tadi. So kita perlukan gradient dengan 1 point. Okay. So therefore the equation of the straight line, y equal to negative 1 over 5x plus by 6. Okay. So times by 5. Okay, so kita hilangkan pembawah dia. So 5y equal to negative x plus 6 times by 5 is 30. Okay. So the question need general equation. We need to left this one just equal to 0. So this one we bring to the left. Okay, so we have x plus 5y minus 30 equal to 0. Okay. So bawa pergi ke kiri, negatif x buat kiri, positif x. And then letak positif 5y. Positif 30 bawa pergi ke kiri, jadi negatif 30. Okay. Okay, so next. Okay, so find the equation of the straight line which passes through negative 1, 5. Okay, so this one, 1 point, the line. Okay, melalui titik negative 1, 5. And then parallel to the line of 9y minus 4x equal to 5. Okay, so parallel, so both line will share the same value of gradient. Okay, so we need to rearrange this one in the form of y equal to mx plus c. So 9y equal to 4x plus 5. So y equal to 4 over 9x plus 5 over 9. Okay, so m is equal to 4 over 9. So using y equal to mx plus c to form the equation of this line. So y equal to m 4 over 9x plus c. And then to find c, use the point given, which is negative 1, 5. So 5 equal to 4 over 9 times negative 1 plus c. Okay, so 5 is equal to negative 4 over 9 plus c. Okay, so c equal to 5 plus by 4 over 9. Okay, so yang ni kita bawa bagi ke kiri. Okay, so tambah 4 per 9. Okay. Okay, so ni kat sini c kat kanan, ni kat kiri. Tak, ni saya terbalikkan macam, terbalikkan kertas macam tu lah. Sudah kan dapat pandangan yang ni. Okay. Okay, so next, calculate C. So we have 5 times 9, 45, 49 over 9. Okay. So therefore, the equation of the straight line is equal to y equal to 4 over 9x plus by 49 over 9 times by 9 to cancel the denominator. So 9y equal to 4x plus 49. Boleh ke tinggal dalam ni sahaja se? Boleh. Okay, so nak tinggal dalam ni pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Okay. Dua-dua betul. Okay, so next, this one question number 8. Okay, so find the equation of a line that passes through. Okay, tertinggal perkataan equation kat sini ni. Okay, so of a line that passes through origin. Okay, so ni ada origin. So ada line ni, dia melalui origin and is perpendicular to the line of 5x. Okay, so the perpendicular to the line of 5x plus y over 3 minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so one point, so this one origin, 0, 0, 1 point. 1 point to find C. Okay. So gradient, so perpendicular, we can use M1 times M2 equal to negative 1. Okay. So rearrange this one in the form of y equal to mx plus C. So y over 3 equal to 5x, bring to the right, become minus 5x. Minus y, bring to the right, and minus 1 become plus 1. Okay, so next, divide by 3, bring to the right, become 3 times by negative 5x plus 1. So equal to negative 15x plus by 3. Okay? So m1 is 15. Okay, so by using this concept, so I have negative 15 times by m2 equal to negative 1. So m2 equal to 1 over 15. Okay? So negative bagi negative positif. So 1 bahagi 15. Okay, so the equation of this line is y equal to mx, which is 1 over 15x plus by c. Okay, so since this one the point origin, so we use this point to find the value of c. x0, y0. So 0 equal to 1 over 15 times by 0 plus c. Okay, so 0 equal to 0 plus c. So therefore, c equal to 0. Okay, so therefore, we have the equation of the straight line, y equal to 1 over 15x. Okay, so cancel denominator times by 15. Y times by 15, 15. Y, 1 over 15 times by 15 is 1, 1x. Okay, so habis kita punya exercise, so dah habis. Okay, so that's all for this video. Okay, so thank you. Assalamualaikum. Assalamualaikum dan jumpa lagi akan datang.